Feet, but under my feet, right? Amen.
Yeah, that's right.
We have the power to do that. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good morning. So good to see you all here today. I don't know. Can you hear me? Hello? Is that better? Now I hear it. Welcome. So good to see you all here. I look forward to our Sunday mornings together. I pray that you do too, but there's something about coming together with family, right? Amen. Amen. We sound like a lively bunch today, don't we? Maybe the wedding wore us out yesterday, huh? Anyway, welcome. Glad you're here. Let's get through these announcements so that we can get back to worship. And there's a couple of announcements that are not in here, so please be mindful when I'll let you know what they are. But anyway, Caring About People will be hosting another Freedom and Healing Weekend next weekend, Friday and Saturday. If you have any questions, you can see Pastor Robert and Lily regarding that. Everyone is welcome, and invite your friends. Sunday, November 10th, we're going to have a Thanksgiving feast, and so be here at 5 p.m. and bring salad and dessert. You know what to do, ladies, when we get together for food. But let's just come together on the 10th at 5, and we'll give God praise and gratitude for what he's done. I don't think I should make this
I'll
next
make
announcement.
This announcement. Verda, you want to make this announcement? I am just so grateful for people like Verda and others who volunteer. And I'm talking to you all because you all engage in different ways to give us an opportunity to serve and to give. And this announcement here next is Pastor Appreciation Month is this month. We want to show them our appreciation for all they've done. Some of us have no clue what all happens in the background. We just come and enjoy and engage, and yet there's a lot that goes on that we don't see. So there is the table in the foyer that we can just ask the Lord what he would want us to do, whether it's a gift, whether it's a gift card, or just a card of encouragement would be a blessing. So whatever you can do, let's show them that we appreciate their love and support and their leadership over this place, because we glean from that. When we have this opportunity, we know that we have gleaned all year long for this moment. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for that. Okay, moving on. So mark your calendars also for December 15th. We'll plan a Christmas party in the fellowship hall. And again, that one will start at 5 p.m. So we've got a very busy season coming up. So make sure that you are marking the dates and make sure you're here. Every Sunday in November is going to be packed with something. So, and we'll get to that in just a minute. But, and then into December as well. So the Christmas party on the 15th, we're planning a trip to Ghana. And we'd love to have as many of you come with us on that trip as would like to go or are able to go. We'll have more details coming up, but you can plan on that the last week in April, the beginning of May. So you can get that on your calendars. If you have more questions, you can see Dan or I. But like I said, we'll have more information to come. Men's prayer meeting every Saturday morning. You're welcome to come and join them in the prayer room. It's about approximately an hour of just simply praying and seeking the heart of God. So come and join in on that. And then just a reminder of our Wednesday evening services. The first and third Wednesdays we'll be meeting here in the sanctuary, and Pastor Dan leads those discussions. So the announcements that are not in here, because it's already full, make sure to be here next Sunday. And the reason I'm pointing this Sunday out is for two reasons. First of all, time changes. So if you don't change your clock, you will miss out. You'll be here an hour early. Sorry, you won't miss out on anything. You'll be here to pray for the service. So that's a great thing, right? Yeah, don't change your clock. Anyway, so time changes next week, but also we are going to have communion service next Sunday. So prepare your hearts for that and come, and it'll be a wonderful, wonderful time. And then on the 17th, November 17th, we are planning to have a special service to commission and install Reuben Beachy as our overseer. And then also that same service, we will install Tim and Vanja as elders and to join our leadership team. So it's a big day. And then we are going to plan a fellowship, right? Yes. There will be a fellowship after that service. So lots happening in November, especially the first three Sundays. Make sure you're here. We want to celebrate what God is doing. Lots of good things, lots of fun happenings. And let's just come together and celebrate. It's a month of Thanksgiving, right? So I'm thankful. I'm grateful for all that God has done here. Just in the past 2 years that Dan and I have been here, it's been amazing. So we welcome you. Come and celebrate with us and join us. And I think that's all that I had. No, I'm sorry. December 7th, just real quick, ladies, get this on your calendar as well. December 7th, it's an anonymous angel reveal party, but also I want to invite all of you to be here because we're going to talk about some plans we have for next year. Okay? So if you're not involved in anonymous angels, we still want you to be here. So please mark your calendars. Be here December 7th at 10 a.m. It'll be a brunch. Excuse me. And then in January, we briefly announced this, and we'll have more details forthcoming. But starting in January, Sunday evenings, we're going to it's called Perspectives Classes, and it's mission-minded, but it's also learning to walk and grow in the purpose that God has for you. So there's a fee to join those classes, and it is not just our church, but it's community-wide. So you have to register, and we'll send out a link for that as well. But we'd love to have all of you here if you can make it. And if you cannot pay the fee, please don't let that stop you. We'll figure out a way to get you here, okay? So just keep that in mind. Starting January 5th, and it'll run about 15 or 16 weeks. So that'll take us through April on Sunday evenings for 3 hours a week. And there's different levels, so you can take the class, just come take it in. You can get certified through this program, but you can also get a college credit for this class. So just keep that in mind, and we'd love to see you there as well. Any other announcements? That was a lot to take in. But just remember, November, just plan to be here every Sunday. And you won't miss a thing. Okay, ushers, if you want to come forward, we'll take up the offering. And while they're coming, I'll just... Did I miss something? I guess not. Dennis and Sharon are not with us again. And so let's be mindful this week, praying for them specifically for healing. Dennis is not feeling well, running a fever. Sharon is still having some health issues. She gets very discouraged and very lonely. So if you can take just a little bit of time, just reach out and let them know that you're thinking of them. Let them know that they mean something to you. That alone brings some healing and some comfort. So if you can, please, I just implore you, reach out. Dennis likes Jell-O and noodle soup. So there you go. Let's practice being the hands and feet of Jesus. We are a body, right? When one body is hurting, the other rest of the body compensates to make up for the hurting part, right? So Jell-O and noodle soup, that's all it takes. It's not hard, right? A phone call, it's not hard, right? So let's just shower them with love and prayers this week. Can we do that? Amen? Okay, let's pray. God, I thank you so much for today. Thank you for allowing us to be here today, for the freedom that we have to come together, to worship you, to serve you in this capacity. And I thank you, God, for this family. God, I thank you so much for the relationships and each person that you have brought into this place. And as it was testified this morning, that we can feel your presence here. And God, when we are in your presence, so much changes. So much happens, God. We become more like you in your presence. And God, we can receive the healing. We can receive redemption. We can receive restoration. Whatever it is in our lives that is lacking or missing, God, you are the one. You are the one that can fill that hole. You are the one that can meet that need. So, Father, I thank you that even when we are not gathered here during a normal worship service, that your presence is still here. So we just thank you for that. And God, I thank you for the gift of jobs, of income. And God, I thank you that we have the opportunity to return a blessing back to you through our tithes and our offerings. And so, Father, as we take up this tithe today, I pray that you would bless each giver and the gift that is given, and Father, that it would be used for your kingdom's sake, and God, that it's all done for your honor and glory because of what you have done for us. We just want to in turn give back to you. So Father, as we even go into our worship time, I pray that our praise and our worship would be an offer of sacrifice to you, and that it would be a pleasing aroma to your nostrils, and God, that you would receive the worship that we give today. And you would receive this tithe to further your kingdom. So we just bless you, we thank you, and we just pray that you continue to be here with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Psalm 103 says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget none of his benefits, who pardons all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with loving kindness and compassion, who satisfies your years with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagle. The Lord performs righteous deeds and judgments for all who are oppressed." Thank you, Lord. Father, we just speak against oppression in Jesus' name. Stand against it. Say you have no authority. In the name of Jesus, we speak health and wholeness and life and peace in Jesus' name.
As we praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord. We're going to give you praise because you're worthy, God, to be praised and lifted up and exalted high above the earth, Lord. Receive honor, glory, and power. There is none that compares to you, O Lord. We come to you, Lord. We come to you. Where else can we go, Father, but to you?
I'm falling on.
you, Lord. It's you, Lord, that we seek.
God, thank you, Father.
When all around seems to be crumbling and we have nowhere else to turn, we can always find hope in you, Lord. You are that friend that sticks closer than a brother. You were always there. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You are our source of life, help and hope. You are the source of life. I can't be left behind. No one else will do. I will take hold of you. 'Cause I need you, Jesus, to come to my rescue. Where else can I go? There's no other name by which I am saved. Capture me with grace. I will follow you. My heart is yours. My heart is yours. For life, I need your hands. In mine, no one else will do. I put my trust in you. Can't be with grace. Oh Lord, I thank you, Lord, for providing what we need. It's you we can turn to anytime.
Spirit, guide us.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Guide us by your Spirit. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Lead and guide us, O God, by your Spirit. Thank you, Father God.
Thank you, Lord, that your salvation comes by the shed blood of Jesus Christ. It's nothing we can do to work our salvation. To work for our salvation. You've provided it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. The risen King.